A pleasant good afternoon and welcome to Range League, Colorado for this afternoon's Scenic West Athletic Conference action between the NIC Cardinals and the Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. This is Dick Halligan. Nice to have you with us as the Cardinals come into the contest 10-2 on the season, 1-1 in Scenic West Athletic Conference action after an 82-59 victory this past Saturday in Price, Utah. Colorado Northwestern, well, they're 8-7 overall. However, 0-3 in conference play, losing to CSI this past Thursday night. Just a few moments ago, we had a chance to talk with Cardinal head coach Chris Carlson. We'll talk about the victory in Price and this afternoon's matchup against the Spartans right after this timeout.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
With Cardinal coach Chris Carlson as Cardinals get set to take on Colorado Northwestern, the Spartans in the final game before the Christmas break. Before we talk about Colorado Northwestern, let's go back to Thursday night. Nice win, first conference win at Utah State Eastern.
Yeah, I was real pleased with that, Dick. You know, as young as we are, to get in the road and swack, and every game's a war out there. So I thought we really stepped up, especially in that third quarter, went 25-10 run right there and kind of blew the game open.
So what was the adjustment that you made at the half then? Obviously you came out and, it seemed like the defense played a whole heck of a lot better.
Yeah, you know, just being solid. You know, sometimes we try to do too much. Sometimes we try to do things too quick. And I think the more we just have a little more patience and work together as a team, the better we're going to be.
One stat that kind of jumped out at me when I was doing the ball game, you're talking about that third period outscoring in 25-10. We didn't commit a single foul in that period. I don't think I can ever recall a period where we did not have a foul.
Yeah. You know, the refs were amazing. That was a great job of reffing. But
that's funny.
No, I guess it was just one of those games, you know, like that, which, with five fouls every quarter putting people at a double bonus, I'm glad we're keeping it down.
Yeah, one player I think that's really starting to improve her game, and that's Jocelyn Cook-Cock. She had 11 points and 5 rebounds, and coming off the bench, she's doing an outstanding job for you.
Yeah, Jocelyn's had some great games, even over in the Christmas the tournament we won in Bellevue. She's been putting together some great stretches for us, and she's a good player.
Also, our featured Meet the Cardinals player also had a pretty good ball game, and that's Gracie Roberts coming off the bench as well.
Yeah, Gracie just continues to get better and better every game. She had some nice assists in that game, and, I just think she's barely on the tip of the iceberg right now.
And the one thing is, it's nice to have a deep bench, isn't it? I mean, it really keeps your options open. If there's foul problems, you got somebody that can step in and doesn't seem to lose a beat.
Yeah, and that's real nice. I mean, when I don't even feel concerned. You know, it just we can run more people in, and sometimes we get more, you know. So it's a nice deep team right now.
All right, final contest before you get into the Christmas break. A Colorado Northwestern team that is struggling a little bit, but you know what? Can't overlook anybody in this conference, can you?
No, you know, they've won a lot of games this year. They are. They're over 500, I think, or right at 500. I've watched some film on them. They play together. They work really hard. They really get back on defense. They're just trying to do some of the basics really well. And I think as a young team, as they start to grow, they're going to be better and better all year long.
You mentioned they're 8-7 in conference play, so they're doing a whole lot better. A question I always like to ask, a couple of things that you talk about prior to the ball game. I suppose I could run past interviews and get this rebounding and take care of the basketball.
Yeah. play defense, rebound, take care of the ball. Yeah. Against Colorado. You know, they threw a little bit of zone stuff at CSI a couple nights ago. And so we're going to have to be ready to attack that and to execute a little bit. And they just work hard. I mean, they really work hard. They have some decent size to them. So we just need to counter those things, and I think we'll have a good day today.
All right, fantastic. A final game before the Christmas break. Everybody looking forward to spending some time with their family. I know coaches, it's not a negative, but they want to get away from the team, and the team probably wants to get away from the coaches, and they all want to get away from the broadcaster. So let's get a win here tonight and go home and enjoy the holidays.
Yeah, it sounds good, Dick. I'm looking forward to a little time off. It's a good time of year for that. You know, my daughter's over playing in Boise right now. They're playing Eagle today and a big matchup over there. And looking forward to getting home and seeing how everything's going with her. And she had three games down there this weekend. So, let's have a good one and get a good trip home and look forward to a nice break.
All right, sounds like a plan. Head coach Chris Carlson, starting lineups and the tip-off right after this timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Welcome back to Range League, Colorado. Just about ready for this afternoon's action. The NIC Cardinals taking on the Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. And we are, both coaching staffs are really anxious to come away with a victory here today and get back to Coeur d'Alene. It's been a pretty good grind here the first month and a half of the season. Of course, the teams will get about a five-day breather before getting back into action. Let's go to the PA announcer for this afternoon's national anthem and the starting lineups. Well, I'm not sure how they're going to do this because I don't see anybody sitting next to the microphone where they have the person that does the starting lineup. As a matter of fact, the folks running the table, the scorer's table, just got here about 3 minutes ago. So not quite sure what we're going to do. All right, somebody just going to walk up and start talking, as I understand. Either that or just going to play the national anthem. We'll just wing it. Here we go. right, I'm just going to go ahead and give the starting lineups because the PA announcer, I think they ran a Craigslist ad to get her. NIC Cardinals come into the contest 10-2 on the season, 1-1 in SWAC conference play. Here's the starting lineups as announced by head coach Chris Carlson. At a guard, a 5'7 sophomore from Lebanon, Oregon, averaging 11 points a ball game, number 12, Macy Benedict. At a forward, 6-foot sophomore from Kamai, Idaho, averaging 15.5 points a ball game and 2.3 steals, number 21, Shelby Cloninger. At a guard, a 5'8 sophomore from Maple Valley, Washington, averaging 13 points, nearly 3 rebounds and 2 assists, number 24, Monica Landeck. At a guard, a 5'10 freshman from Meridian High School, averaging 8.5 points and 5 rebounds, 2 assists, number 32, Ebony Norman. And in the middle for the Cardinals, and she will also be our special guest on Meet the Cardinals, Stormy Van Bell, a 6-foot sophomore from Sunnyside, Washington, averaging 11 points, 8 rebounds, and 2.5 assists. For Colorado Northwestern, at a guard, number 5, Riley Thompson, averaging 4 points a game. At a guard, a freshman, averaging 8.7 points per game, Rachel Prescott. Shelby Harvey is the center, averaging 7 points a ball game. And another guard is a freshman, number 30, Kylie Tui Mauna. And we are underway, and Colorado Northwestern will get the basketball for the first time here this afternoon. And a travel right off the bat. That's Tyra Rodriguez, a sophomore, with the turnover. And the Cardinals will get it first. Or actually, their first opportunity at the basket. And you can see the glare coming in one of the open windows off the snow, and we'll see if that affects the players. Macy Benedict with the runner, and it's blocked by Thompson. And the Spartans will bring it in the forecourt. And there's another window that's in the gym that could cause problems as Van Bell for the Cardinals gets the steal. Foul going to be called on Thompson as the Cardinals were trying to get the ball inside to Shelby Cloninger. And I hope I didn't. Did I miss Shelby on the starting lineup? 6-foot sophomore from Kamai? I did not. All right. Things were kind of disheveled, to say the least, to start things off here. In the lane, Norman doesn't get it. Cloninger with the offensive rebound. Doesn't go. Gets it back again. And then lays it in. Shelby Cloninger with the hustle play for the Cardinals. From the left elbow, shot off the glass and in by Prescott, and we are tied. In Rangeley, Colorado, a very cold 3 degrees this morning, but the sun is out, which just makes it feel so much warmer, doesn't it? Prescott. Three ball from Prescott, and she puts it in. So the Spartans with the early lead as we just get things underway here in the first period in Rangeley, Colorado. Monica Landeck looking for some space. Cloninger with a three. Rattles and doesn't drop. And Prescott with a rebound. Thompson has it knocked away by Cloninger. Rumbling down the lane is Prescott. And a foul on the Cardinals. And they get Cloninger for the foul, her first. Prescott with a three, comes up short, and Macy Benedict grabs the air ball. Looking inside for Van Bell, Cloninger launches the three and gets it, and boy, that's got to be a confidence booster for Shelby. And we are tied at five. 7:19 remaining first period. From the left side, Harvey doesn't go. Cloninger with a rebound and a foul. And we'll see who the foul is on. Well, they don't. If I don't hear them announce the foul, they don't put them up on the board. Grace Varco in the ball game for Shelby Cloninger, so that may have been on her. That could have been her second. You can see that glare from the window right in your screen. Out of bounds. Lost control to Midgley. And it's out of bounds to the Cardinals. And I'm not going to spend my whole day talking about some of the issues that both coaches and broadcasters face, but I guarantee you there is a bunch of them. Ball is loose. Van Bell has it, and then she's fouled. It'll be Cardinal ball on the baseline. And Riley Thompson charged with a personal foul. Both teams now with two team fouls early in the ball game. Nice to have you with us here on this nice Saturday, nice winter day. Norman with a three, doesn't go. And a foul inside as Van Bell grabbed the rebound. Fouls on Rachel Prescott. Third team foul on the Spartans. Benedict will inbound. Macy launches a three, too strong. And two Cardinals run after it and out of bounds. Van Bell and Norman both going after it. Couldn't control it, and it's Spartan basketball. 6:26 remaining first period. Midgley and throws it away. She had a path to the basket and chose to pass, and there was nobody home. Taylor Martin checks in the ball game for Shelby Harvey, for head coach Brian Ortmeier of Colorado Northwestern. Van Bell, turnaround jump shot. Doesn't get it, but was fouled. And she'll go to the free throw line. Fourth team foul on Colorado Northwestern, so we'll be shooting free throws in a short amount of time. Taylor Thomas checks in for Colorado Northwestern along with Megan Erickson. One more for Stormy. Once again, Stormy will be our guest, halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals. She has a fun little story if you're a Seahawks fan. That'll be coming up at halftime. Three ball from downtown, and Prescott gives Colorado Northwestern the lead from long range. Van Bell left alone, she'll launch the three, doesn't get it, but chases the rebound down. Off the glass and in. Nice hustle play that time for Stormy Van Bell. Midgley. Prescott, she's got a pretty good shot from outside. She launches another three, and she's got another three. Prescott with nine in the ball game, and as a matter of fact, she only averages 8.7. So in the first, 5 minutes of the ball game, she's already made her scoring average. Just under 5 minutes remaining in the first period. Norman in the lane. Little jump hook is good. We're tied. overthrown pass intended for Erickson. The Cardinals come up with it. Norman looking inside for Varco, doesn't get it to her. Cardinals will reverse it, and a steal. Prescott with a steal. Going to go the full way, lays it up and in. And Prescott has 9 of her team's 13 points, or 11 of her team's 13 points. Benici Benedict with a 3, doesn't go. Van Bell with an offensive rebound and puts it back in, and we're tied. Stormy Van Bell having herself a good early ball game. Just under 4 minutes remaining in the first period. Backdoor cut. Erickson off the glass. Doesn't go. Fouled by Van Bell. And a media timeout. Yes, indeed. We'll take one. 3:44 remaining. We got a good one going. We'll be right back.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you. Which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Welcome back to Rangeley, Colorado. There we are from our broadcast location. Cardinals will wrap up the first half, if you will, of the season and wrap up before the Christmas break. Lady Cardinals will have a tournament in, I believe, Bellevue. And we'll get more on that here coming up in just a second. I should have checked that prior. But the men, of course, they'll have the Coeur d'Alene Invitational Tournament beginning on the 28th. So we'll have more on that. And let's go to the free throw line, and shooting is Megan Erickson. .344 remaining in the first period. A couple of changes for Chris Carlson, Charity Marlatt in the ball game, along with Jocelyn Cook Cox. Inside, Cook Cox doesn't get it. Varco with the offensive board. And kicking it, did Grace. And out of bounds to Colorado Northwestern. And trying to force it inside that time. Trying to get it to Martin. And wide right. And out of bounds. Cardinals get it with the turnover as we approach 3 minutes remaining in the first. Benedict. To Cox from the elbow. Off the glass, too strong. Rebound comes down to Rodriguez. Thomas looking inside. Three ball. Midgley. Too strong. Offensive rebound. Rodriguez. New shot clock for Colorado Northwestern. 2:36 remaining in the first. Les Case also win for the Cardinals. Blocked by Marlatt. And called for the foul. We'll reset your Cardinal lineups. Benedict, Marlatt, Case, Cook, Cox, and Varco. Midgley at the free throw line, 61% free throw shooter. Gracie Roberts in the ball game for Macy Benedict. Roberts down the lane. Scoop shot doesn't go. Rodriguez trying to barrel her way through, not able to. Martin tried to post inside. Long three ball comes up short for Midgley. And Cook Hawks with a rebound. Ahead to Case. Case from the left elbow doesn't go. Rebound to Colorado Northwestern. Cardinals a little cool in their shooting here early on in the ball game. Driving to the baseline, doesn't go. Thomas, offensive rebound by Martin, and a held ball as Roberts and Martin tied it up. Possession no points to North Idaho College. Actually, it points towards Vernal, Utah, but they don't say that. Eh? Roberts looking for some help. Traveled. 1:30 remaining first period. Colorado Northwestern coming in at 8-7 on the season, 0-3 in conference. Right now they're playing much better than the Cardinals. Rodriguez shot is up. And Case got away with a little push and then on the rebound. Foul is called on Megan Erickson of the Spartans. So that's the fifth team foul on Colorado Northwestern. So we'll take the walk down the other side, and Marlatt will be shooting a pair of free throws for NIC. Charity is 50% free throw shooter. She has not had a lot of opportunities. Ellie Tuamani, or Tuamana, in the ball game for Colorado Northwestern, and Charity gets them both. Once again, Stormy Van Bell, our halftime guest, coming up on Meet the Cardinals. Roberts ends up with the deflected ball. Under a minute. Case back to Roberts. We'll look inside for Varco. They get it to her. Grace in the lane. Shot is up. Bounces and does not go. And held ball. And boy, the Colorado Northwestern bench wanted a foul as it appeared that Marlatt was over the top of Erickson to tie her up. However, with the possession arrow, the Spartans get the basketball anyway. 42 seconds remaining. Case with a reach in foul for NIC. And that's the 15th foul on NIC. So Rachel Prescott will go to the free throw line to shoot two. 85% free throw shooter. So she's the gal, if you're a Spartan, that you want on the free throw line. Prescott averages 8.7 points, 3.5 rebounds, and she's already in the double figures. Seconds remaining, first period. Case down the lane. Left-handed shot is blocked by Erickson. And a traveling call on Jocelyn Cook-Cox as the home team, or the home fans below us, are hooping and hollering a little bit. A very sparse crowd, I'd say less than two dozen, but they're right below me, so you're going to hear them. 15 seconds in the first period. Prescott. 8 seconds. Good hedge that time by Varco. Pass inside, knocked away by Marlatt. Cardinals have it. 3 seconds. Roberts with a long shot. Doesn't go. And there's your first period of action. Colorado Northwestern with a 3-point lead. And we'll be back to Rangeley right after this timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Welcome back to Rangeley, Colorado on a very nice Saturday afternoon. Hopefully the weather is great back in North Idaho and Eastern Washington, all you folks that are watching us here tonight. The Cardinals, well, they'll try to get it together here to start the second period. They'll start off with the same five as they ended the period with. And don't forget, Stormy Van Bell is our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals. All right, we're ready for the second half, and here we go. Inside to Van Bell in the lane. Case, three ball, too strong. And an over-the-top foul on Stormy Van Bell. First team foul to start the second period. You can see the sun coming through the windows here at Colorado Northwestern. And a blocking foul on Van Bell, so that's really going to put her in foul trouble. And she immediately walks to the bench because she knows that she'll have to come out. And I'm not sure how many. That might be three. I don't have a book, and they don't put it up on the score clock. Prescott. Three ball, Harvey. Varco grabs the rebound for the Cardinals. Boy, she has been solid rebounding for NIC this year. Grace will launch it. Short. Cardinals continue cool shooting here in Rangeley, Colorado. And a pushing foul. Yes, she did. Alyssa Case with a push. And already that's the third team foul on the Cardinals. And the 85% free throw shooter missed it. Monica Landeck back in for Case. Remember, after the fifth team foul in any of the four quarters, it's a double bonus. Gone is the 1-1. So it's the largest lead of the ball game so far for Colorado Northwestern. Inside Barco, off the glass, missed it. NIC just not able to finish on the inside. They've had numerous opportunities. Stolen. Roberts just picked her pocket. Roberts. And kind of an off-balance, tough shot for Gracie that time, but she will go to the free throw line to shoot a pair. And we'll catch up with all the fouls, shooting stats, and scoring recap at the half. As I hope They keep stats. Not being Shelby Harvey in the ball game, but the scores table arrived with 4 minutes remaining to start the ball game. So, and she missed them both. Boy, that there is a lid on that bucket, to use an old cliche. Rebound, Charity Marlatt. She'll hold it up. In the corner, Landak will run the lane. Missed the lay-in. Varco, offensive rebound, and puts it in, and it counts. Grace Varco. Hopefully that'll give the Cardinals a spark. Varco averaging nearly 5 points a ball game, but more importantly, over 8 rebounds. And she missed it. 7:44 remaining in the half. And a steal. Nicely timed that time. Jocelyn Cook Cox goes to the lane and lays it in. And we're tied. Nice overplay that time by the Nine Mile Falls Washington product. Prescott, who she wanted to shoot it. Good defense that time by Landek. Three ball from downtown. Nothing but the bottom of the net that time by Tuimana. Under 7 minutes remaining to the half. Inside, and a foul from behind. Taylor Martin with a push on Charity Marlatt. Ebony Norman getting set to come back in for NIC. Taylor Thomas and Tyra Rodriguez back for Colorado Northwestern. Charity Marlatt goes to the bench. Norman rumbles to the lane, shot off the glass at end. And the Cardinals are only down one. Rodriguez down the lane. And knocked out of bounds that time by Grace Varco, who was in position for the steal but couldn't control it. Out of bounds to Colorado Northwestern. 6:35 remaining in the first half. 20 on the shot clock. And a travel called on Rodriguez. Cardinals starting to pick up the defensive intensity here. And Chris Carlson wants to take a 30-second timeout. We'll be right back. 6:33 remaining in the half. We'll be back after this word from Numerica Credit Union.
Thank you for taking me out.
This place is beautiful.
It's nice to get away.
It is lovely. It's lovely.
Surprise!
Look who's here.
This place is nice.
Hey, whoa. Hey, that's mine.
Honey, what's wrong?
We know what gets on your nerves. That's why Numerica makes it easy for members to make the most of their money with lower interest rates on loans, higher rates on deposits, and zero hidden fees. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
Welcome back to Rangeley, Colorado. NIC Cardinals taking on the Spartans of Colorado Northwestern. Of course, the teams will be heading back right after the men's game. And we're expecting to get back in the Coeur d'Alene area right around maybe 11 o'clock, depending on what time we actually get out of here. Roberts will bring it in the forecourt. Looking inside for Norman, who's now posted down below. Wide open, Landek. Landek off the glass, doesn't go. Knocked out of bounds to the Cardinals. Inside Norman. shot is up, doesn't go. Varco offensive rebound, and Grace Varco gives the Cardinals the lead. I misspoke earlier. The Cardinals will play in the Lower Columbia College Tournament beginning on the 28th. Down low for Colorado Northwestern, Martin misses the shot. And Gracie Roberts will bring it in the forecourt. My memory was kind of foggy. Jocelyn Cook-Cox with a three. No good. Norman offensive rebound looking for some help. Gets it out. Landak open three. Got it. Monica Landak. And just like that, the Cardinals are roaring back up by four. NIC now in full court pressure. Rodriguez able to dribble through the press. Baseline Thomas. Shot is blocked from behind by Cook-Cox. And Landak will come out of the pack. Cardinal defense definitely stepping up here. Long three. Norman doesn't go. Ball is batted. And Harvey comes down with it. Wow, that was an NBA three by Ebony Norman. Although she was putting that down in practice. Rodriguez drives to the lane. 4:50 remaining in the first half. Offensive foul as Gracie Roberts tried to clear the defender. Varco out of the ball game. And Charity Marlatt back in. 4:36 remaining in the first half. Coming in for the first time, Clarissa Smith. And she replaces Jocelyn Cook-Cox. So Chris Carlson going to use just about his entire bench as he always does. Now Cardinals little trapping defense. Ball is loose. Midgley for three, banks it in. And just like that, Colorado Northwestern with five straight to come back and take the lead. And held ball, possession arrow to Colorado Northwestern. Macy Benedict back in the ball game for Gracie Roberts. Cardinals with full court pressure. And shot clock. And they didn't. Seconds is what they reset it to. 4 minutes exactly remaining in the first half. Stormy Van Bell, our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals. Spartans beat the press. Midgley. Prescott, eight on the shot clock. 3 seconds. Shot off at the buzzer that time by Reynolds. Doesn't go. Offensive rebound. And a foul called inside on the Cardinals. I think they're going to get Charity Marlatt with a reach in. They do. And that's the 15th foul on the Cardinals. So for the final 3:29, Colorado Northwestern will be shooting two shots. Harvey, 55% free throw shooter. Offensive board. Off the glass. Does not go that time to Amamana. Charity with a rebound. Ahead to Landak. Smith. Charity, nice play. Marlatt with a lay-in. Nice pass by Smith. And we are tied. Going coast to coast. And laying it in that time. to Imana. And a foul called on Sierra Reynolds. So that's the fourth team foul on Colorado Northwestern. It'll be out of bounds to NIC. Inside to Smith. Missed the lay-in. Nice run play by the Cardinals. Just didn't finish. NIC now in a zone. Three ball does not go by Midgley. Ball is loose. And saved by Reynolds, but and then throws it out of bounds, trying to save it. It'll be Cardinal ball, 2.5 minutes remaining in the first half. So Macy Benedict will set things up with a bucket. Cardinals can tie it up. Long three. There it is. Monica Landeck says, the heck with tying it up. We want the lead, and her three does that. Midgley tried to get it inside to Reynolds and threw it away. 2:06 remaining in the first half. Jocelyn Cook-Cox in the ball game, along with Alyssa Case, as Landeck and Norman get a breather. So Benedict, Marlatt, Case, Smith, Cook-Cox. Only one starter for the Cardinals on the court right now, and that's Benedict. Case from the right elbow, got it. 1:43 remaining. Open three from outside. Does not go that time by Midgley. Offensive rebound and an over-the-head shot. Unbelievable shot that time by Tui Mana. Wow. Benedict has it blocked from behind by Prescott. Prescott goes to the ground, continues to dribble. And a small but very vociferous crowd here in Rangeley supporting the home team. There's another three from the left side, short this time. Offensive board inside by Reynolds. Held ball, possession arrow to North Idaho College. To Amana, that over the head, off the backboard and in shot. That's one of those when you're playing a game of horse. Over the head, off the backboard, and in. Okay. Benedict. Shot by Macy. Doesn't go. And here comes the Spartans. Midgley in the front court. Cardinals just are not getting the shots to drop. Cross court. Prescott. Step around move. Off the glass and in. Colorado Northwestern looking for their first conference victory, and boy, they're coming out with fire here this afternoon. Benedict steps back and then comes back again. Reverse lay-in shot. Nice move and nice finish by Macy Benedict. 3 seconds left. Shot from the left side does not go. And there's your halftime score, as the Cardinals lead it by one, 35-34. Coming up next, our halftime guest on Meet the Cardinals. We'll hear from one Stormy Van Bell right after this timeout.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you. Which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Welcome to another edition of Meet the Cardinals, and joining us is Stormy Van Bell from Sunnyside, Washington. How in the heck are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Well, let's talk a little bit about your game and how you actually ended up in NIC. From Sunnyside, Washington, you went to the East Coast, I understand.
Yeah, I went 25 miles north of Boston to Merrimack College, and it's a four-year D2 school, so...
How did you end up going there? I mean, talk about the process coming out of, you know, Sunnyside, Washington, and all of a sudden you're on the East Coast. How in the heck did that happen?
Well, they were, like, the only college recruiting me and looking at me. So, I mean, it was just a shot in the dark, and let's go give it a shot. And, I mean, there was nothing stopping me from going to the East Coast, give something new to try.
You didn't become a New England Patriot fan, did you?
No, I had a 12 flag flying out of my dorm room window. So.
You are. Isn't she awesome? That is absolutely awesome. What was it like back there? Did you like it? And how did you end up coming back to North Idaho College?
I actually liked it. It was a different experience for me. The competition was really tough because we were in a conference with the reigning champs of the national D2. So it was difficult to play against them, and it was hard. And we beat them in overtime on their court, so it was really cool. It was really cold. There was record-breaking snow storms and stuff there, so that was not fun.
I mean, it lasted till almost July, didn't it? They had a big mountain of snow, and they were holding raffles and stuff on when it would finally melt.
Yeah, really, though. We had, like, a 20-foot snow drift on the campus, and we would climb it and stuff for fun.
Talk about the basketball learning curve going from high school to playing in college on the East Coast. Talk about that.
It was a tough transition. It was just a day in, day out thing. We just worked hard, I was the only freshman on the team, so there was a lot of experience to learn from. So I just really watched the coaches and how they really helped me get through that process and stuff. So it was kind of easy because I was the only freshman. And plus, I just worked hard, and that was my job, basically.
I was going to say, a lot of times freshmen walk in with their eyes wide open. What were a couple of things that maybe caught you by surprise? Most say speed of the game is a lot faster.
Yes, it was way faster. Even though I played club AU, it was really faster than that even, and that's a huge step from even high school basketball. So it was interesting. The thing that really got me off guard was the weight training. The weights were pretty much every morning at 5 o'clock. You had to be up, ready to go.
Nice.
And yeah, it was really tough, but it taught you discipline and how to be ready and how to show up every day for basketball and everything. So
how do you end up at NIC? I mean, did you call around? Did you, you know, say, hey, you know, I want to come back home? Or
yeah, I really wanted to be close to home, and it's only a 3.5-hour drive from my house. And I was actually looking at other schools too. I emailed everybody, and they were the only ones that had a spot on this roster. And I was like, okay, why not? Let's give it a shot too.
And what do you say about your decision?
I made a great decision. I made an awesome decision.
So how about some of your teammates? How are they getting along with you?
I think we're all getting along pretty well. I love this team, and it's been a really fun year so far.
All right. She's doing very well. 11 points, 8 rebounds, 2.5 assists, 1.5 steals, and probably even offered to drive the team bus. I'm not quite sure. All right. Let's get off the court stuff. Let's talk about some of the personal stuff. With a name by Stormy, what are some of the nicknames that some of your players have come up with over the years?
Well, just shortening it to Storm. A couple of teammates have called me Storm Cloud. That's been the one that's really stuck. So that's about it.
Yeah. All right. Now, you're big. Obviously, if you go to New England and you fly a 12 flag, you got to be a Seahawk fan.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah,
right. Hobbies outside of basketball. You know, a lot of times girls, you know, they say, well, I get with my friends and we play basketball and blah, blah, blah. But come on, tell me something. What do you like to do when you're not playing hoops?
I really like to go boating during the summer. That's the best. We like to ride four-wheelers. I just love being home with my dogs and everything, and I'm a homebody. I love being around family. So.
Okay, what kind of dogs you got?
I got a lab, and he's my favorite, and he's Jib. And we have a little miniature wiener dog, and that's Wilma.
Wilma the wiener dog, and Jeb. So you don't tell the wiener dog that, you know, Jeb is your favorite? You don't do that?
Oh, sometimes.
Do you really? Like, how would you explain to us here how you would tell the wiener dog that, hey, Jeb's our favorite?
Well, I pet and be with my other dog more, so I think she gets the drift.
She sits outside and pouts, right?
Well, she has my dad, and he
wiener dogs. Wiener dogs are like that, aren't they?
Oh yeah.
Do you like to cook? Do you like to eat?
I love to eat. I'm not a very good cook. I'm all about quick, easy, fast things. I love my mom's cooking; it's the best. And yeah, I don't cook much.
I try not to cook much either, but look, it doesn't look like I've missed too many meals either, does it? All right, going home for the holidays, any special plans?
Just being with family.
That's fun, isn't it?
Yeah, that's my favorite thing, just being around family. And, yeah, I don't know what we're doing. That's the fun part.
So would you buy Jeb and the wiener dog for Christmas?
A bone.
Yeah, a bone. All right. Well, Stormy, appreciate your time, and welcome back to home, as we will, back from the East Coast. You can fly the 12 flag proudly and save some room there for a Cardinal flag as well.
Oh, yes.
All right, by the way, shout-outs. Go ahead. Anybody want to say hi to?
My friends and family back home and some of my good friends on the East Coast. My dogs at home because I love them.
Say hi to the wiener dog.
Yeah, and I think that's about it.
All right, that's awesome. Yeah, Stormy Mandel, this is another edition of Meet the Cardinals.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Welcome back to Rangeley, Colorado. There's your halftime score with the Cardinals hanging on to a one-point lead, 35-34. Let's look at some of your halftime shooting stats. And as we were talking about in that first half, the Cardinals just missed a lot of shots inside. Cardinals shooting 35% from the field, 14 of 40, only 16% from beyond the arc. The Cardinals are 2 of 12 and 57% from the free throw line, 4 of 7. No Cardinal in that first half in double figures, led by the 6 points of Stormy Vandell. Stormy was 6. Problem with Stormy, though, is she has 3 fouls in that first half, so she will definitely have to tread lightly. Other scores for the Cardinals: Shelby Cloninger and Monica Landeck both have 5 points in that first half. 4 points apiece for Grace Varco and Charity Marlatt. Also in the ball game, Ebony Norman had 4 points, 2 apiece for Alyssa Case and Jocelyn Cook Cox. For Colorado Northwestern, no, they shoot 41% from the field, 11 of 27, 5 of 11, 45% from beyond the arc, and they're shooting 70%, 7 of 10 from the free throw line. 18 points in the first half, game high for Rachel Prescott. She had, oh, goodness sakes, 3 of 3 from beyond the arc, 9 points from beyond the arc, and she had a couple of other field goals and free throws. As a matter of fact, that I can check my stat sheet here. Rachel Prescott, as we mentioned earlier, only averaging 8.7 points per ball game, so she's definitely above her scoring average. No one else for Colorado Northwestern in double figures. Tuamana, she had 7, 5 for Midgley, and 2 points for Rodriguez, 1 point for Shelby Harvey. Rebounding in that first half, it was Colorado Northwestern now rebounding the Cardinals 23-22. Leading rebound for the Spartans, Prescott and Rodriguez both with 3. For the Cardinals, well, they had 4 rebounds apiece from Grace Varco and Charity Marlatt. Turnovers in the ballgame, 7 for the Cardinals, 14 in that first half for Columbia Basin. So the Cardinals were taking care of the basketball. They just didn't shoot as well as they would have liked in that first half. Let's see here. Personal fouls, 3 for Stormy Van Bell. We mentioned that. 2 in the first half for Shelby Cloninger. 2 for Alyssa Case. And as a matter of fact, they have it's hard to read this stat sheet because everything's turned around the way that you normally would see it. 2 fouls for Case and 2 for Cloninger. Other than that, no real problems for the Cardinals. Personal fouls for Columbia Basin. For Colorado Northwestern, Riley Thompson with 3. I mentioned Columbia Basin. Lower Columbia College is where the Cardinals will be when they come back from the holiday break on the 28th. They'll be in Longview, Washington. So we're just about ready for the second half of action. The Cardinals by 1. We'll see what type of changes each team makes during the half. Both teams on the court. We'll be back with the second half after this break.
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Anslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
By the way, one final bit of information I want to pass along here before we start the second half. The score was tied 6 times, and the lead changed hands 10 times, just to kind of show you how close this ball game certainly has been in the first half. They put a couple of extra seconds back on the clock, so we'll actually get an opportunity to tell you this word from Les Schwab Tires.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, well, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires good to have?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Welcome back to Rangeley, Colorado, the Cardinals. We'll come back with their starting for actually, that's incorrect. Grace Varco will start the second half in place of Stormy Van Bell, who has those 3 personal fouls. So the Cardinals will with Cloninger, Varco, Norman, Landeck, and Benedict as we start the second half here in Rangeley, Colorado, and carrying the basketball is Prescott, and right away a turnover sends the ball back to North Idaho College. So we'll see the adjustments that Coach Carlson for the Cardinals and Ortmeier for the Spartans make in the second half as Norman misses a long three. Held ball with a pair of 21s. Cloninger for the Cardinals, Harvey for the Spartans, and possession arrow points to NIC. Cloninger from the right baseline, too strong. Norman with a rebound. Not much arch on that shot that time by Shelby. Just caught the back iron. Norman in the Cloninger, or check that to Cloninger. Cloninger with a bucket, and the Cardinals increase the lead to three here to start the second half. Prescott with that very impressive first half. My goodness, 18 points, and she averages under nine. Little runner in the lane comes up short for Rodriguez. And quickly, here comes Macy Benedict in the front court. Benedict pass off to Landek, who lays it up and in. And a kick ball as Benedict almost came up with a steal. And right away, Colorado Northwestern wants a timeout to talk about it. We'll do the same. 8:44 remaining. I'll talk to myself during the break.
Thank you for taking me out.
This place is beautiful.
It's nice to get away.
It's lovely.
It's good. Oh. Surprise!
Look who's here.
This place is nice.
Hey, whoa. Hey, that's mine.
Honey, what's wrong?
We know what gets on your nerves. That's why Numerica makes it easy for members to make the most of their money with lower interest rates on loans, higher rates on deposits, and zero hidden fees. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
Hi, Jim and Sunny with the all-new Subaru Outback. The symmetrical all-wheel drive system has the capability to take you almost anywhere. There's also extensive safety features like driver eyesight assist, blind spot detection, and Subaru vehicle dynamics control. More good news, at 33 miles per gallon, it's the most fuel efficient crossover in America. Visit Parker Subaru, just off Highway 95 in Coeur d'Alene.
Welcome back to Range Lake, Colorado. You know, you always wish that you could have a microphone in at the halftime to hear what the coaches say and some of the adjustments. But one thing that the Cardinals definitely have done, they've come out with a little bit more intensity. And they've scored the first 4 points of this second half. And we'll see what Coach Brian Ortmeier has done for his squad. Prescott looking for somebody to get it to. Wide open underneath. Shot up but missed. An easy shot by Martin, and Cloninger with a rebound. Benedict goes all the way. Lays it up with the left hand. Nice drive by Macy Benedict with the left hand. Nice grab by Prescott. Boy, she looked like a wide receiver in football with that grab. Inside to Martin. And she traveled. Cardinal pressure. Second turnover in the second half for Colorado Northwestern as Riley Thompson back in the ball game for Brian Ortmeier. Barco, Cloninger, inside, partially blocked, and then saves it. What a play by Shelby. Inside, Cloninger lays it up with the left hand. Knocked out of bounds by Landek. Sarah Midgley coming back in the ball game, replacing to Amana. 7:20 remaining third period. Boy, the Cardinals have really come out aggressively to start this second half. They just weren't making the shots in the first half, only shooting 35%. That's not like NIC. They shoot well over 40%, and there's another turnover on the travel. Stormy Van Bell coming in for Shelby Cloninger. And substitution also coming in for Colorado Northwestern, Taylor Thomas, gives Pyra Rodriguez a little breather. Landeck. Cardinals on an 8-0 run to start this second half. Macy Benedict from beyond the arc. And just like that, it's a 12-point Cardinal lead. Rumbling down the lane, doesn't go. Good defense by Varco on the Thompson shot. Norman hustles in the front court. Inside, Van Bell, nobody on her, turns around, jump shot is good. Cardinals putting it to the Spartans right now. And the home crowd is silent. Jump shot from the left side is short by Midgley. Benedict with his rebound. Ahead to Landeck. Landeck lays it up and in. Cardinals and another timeout by the Spartans. 16-point NIC lead. And will it be a 30 or will it be a 60? It's going to be a full timeout. We'll take a full timeout as well. We'll be right back to Rangeley, Colorado.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
What a start for the Cardinals. A 15-0 run to start this third quarter. 15 points in 4 minutes for the Cardinals, and they continue full court pressure. And almost a turnover. Midgley. Eight on the shot clock. And a double dribble. Yes, it was. And boy, Brian Ortmeier was really upset on that call. He's trying anything he can right now to get his team to, like, wake up a little bit here. Cardinals are really putting it to him. Norman with a three. Doesn't go. Knocked out of bounds by Van Bell. Kelsey Harvey in the ball game for Taylor Thomas. 5:20 remaining third quarter. Cardinals had a heck of a third quarter against Eastern this past Thursday, as you remember. Cardinals outscored Eastern 25-10. Shot from the right side doesn't go. Van Bell with a rebound. Third quarter has been kind to the Cardinals as of late. Benedict. Macy in the lane, off the glass, doesn't go. Varco battles for it. Knocked out of bounds, too. Colorado Northwestern. Taylor Martin back in the ball game, replacing Harvey. Norman gets a breather for the Cardinals and Jocelyn Cook-Cox back on the floor. It's Chris Carlson rotating his players to keep them fresh, going after this full court pressure. Prescott going to set it up. From the right side, doesn't go. Shot missed that time by Thompson, but she is fouled from behind by Jocelyn Cook-Cox. First foul of the third quarter by any player, or either team, probably a better way to put that. And the streak is finally over for Colorado Northwestern. Cardinals, a 15-0 run to start the third quarter. Charity Marlatt in the ball game for Grace Varco. Thompson, a 67% free throw shooter. And missed it. Ball is loose, and Van Bell ends up with it. They head to Cook-Cox. Cook-Cox spin move and throws it up at the basket to avoid the travel and doesn't get iron. And the Spartans have it. Midgley finally gets the bucket. First field goal of the second half for Colorado Northwestern. Landeck. Back to Jocelyn Cook-Cox. In the lane, has it checked by Harvey, and a foul was called. Boy, that looked like a pretty good block that time. And Brian Ortmeier on the Spartan bench just kind of shaking his head. His team has just been steamrolled here in the first 6 minutes of this third period. Alyssa Case in for Monica Landeck. One more for Cook-Cox, and the lefty puts it in. Carissa Smith in the lineup for NIC. Jocelyn Cook-Cox get a breather. Going to get some instructions from Coach Carlson. NIC defensive pressure all over the court. Shot from 10, bounces and drops that time. And that basket by Midgley. I couldn't see her number. Benedict gets it in to Van Bell. Turnaround jump shot from 8. Short rebound. Actually a little strong. Any description didn't make it. Left side, 8-footer. Thompson comes up short. And hustling for the rebound is Prescott. So Midgley will be out on top. Prescott moved from the point to the shooting position. Midgley for 3, partially blocked and out of bounds to NIC as Prescott took a shot going inside. And the Cardinals will inbound at 2:57 remaining in this third quarter. ...17-5 run to start this period for NIC. Benedict, bad pass, knocked out of bounds. Spartan ball, Macy looking for some help, didn't get it. He had to try to force it in there and turnover. And just like that, oh, and stepped on the baseline. Speaking of an unforced error, Harvey tossed it to Prescott, who momentarily lost control and then slid onto the baseline to try to save it out of bounds. Gracie Roberts in the ball game as Macy gets a little breather. Cloninger, a 3. Got it! Shelby Cloninger from beyond the arc. We'll reset your Cardinal lineup in just a moment. 2:26 remaining, knocked out of bounds by Case. So the Cardinals have Case, Cloninger, Marlatt, Smith, and Roberts. Cloninger, the only starter. And off Marlatt's foot as Midgley tried to dribble between three Cardinal defenders and lost it. Tuamana back in the ball game for Midgley, who will get some coaching on the sideline from Brian Ortmeier, not to try to dribble between a zone defense. Ball tapped out of bounds by Cloninger. 2:18 remaining third period. Man, what a third period it has been for NIC. Seven on the shot clock. Long three doesn't go that time by Tuamana. Offensive board goes to the Spartans. Smith tries to save it. Look out. And out of bounds to NIC. And boy, I tell you what, you see that glass door that Clarissa Smith was headed to. And oh boy, you hold your breath. As you can see, the sun comes through those doors and windows here at Colorado Northwestern. Smith looking inside for Cloninger. Top of the circle, that's a two. Gracie Roberts puts it down. 1:35 remaining. Prescott, right side, doesn't come up, or doesn't go down, actually. And a foul. One 11 remaining in the third. Tyra Rodriguez in the ball game for Kelsey Harvey. As far as fouls, both teams with only one personal foul in this third period. The last third period at Price, Utah on Thursday, Cardinals did not have a foul at all in the third quarter. Smith misses the jump shot. We'll go the other way. And it's strange. Sometimes no fouls. Sometimes you get them by the buckets. Ball tipped by Roberts. Inside, blocked by Marlatt. Oh, that looked like a pretty good block. Chris Carlson just kind of chuckles and throws his palm up. It's like, geez, that did look like a pretty good block. 43.3 seconds remaining. This was a one-point Cardinal lead at the half, 35-34. Marlatt, long jump shot, it's good! Charity Marlatt with a 19-footer. 26 seconds remaining. Prescott has been held scoreless in this third quarter after scoring 18 in the first two. 12 seconds remaining. Knocked away by Case. 8 seconds. Long shot to Amana. Not good. 3 seconds. Blocked by Marlatt. And did we call a foul? We got a foul. A foul is called on Cloninger. And ball on Shelby Cloninger. And trying to see in my stats, that's going to be her second, third foul. One more for Megan Erickson. And she's got it. And that's the end of the third period. We'll be back with a final 10 minutes, Cardinals in control. We'll be right back after this timeout.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm, you know, from...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica, life moves, live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
This is almost a carbon copy of what we saw last Thursday night with the Cardinals taking on Utah State Eastern. In that third period, the Cardinals outscored Eastern 25-10. Here in Rangeley, Colorado, they outscored the Spartans 24-9. We'll see what happens here in the fourth and final period with the Cardinals out comfortably in front. So the Cardinals have Case, Roberts, Smith, Varco, and Cloninger on the floor. Ball tapped away by Roberts. Open three, Case short. Offensive rebound by Roberts. Smith for three, offline, you could tell. Ball batted and grabbed by Rodriguez. Pass inside, blocked by Roberts, and oh man, Roberts can't believe that. Carlson, you can probably hear me say, that's a horrible call. And coach, I'll just leave it at that. It looked pretty good. Midgley out of the ball game, or actually into the ball game, and gets him. Inside, Cloninger. Pass, lay-in, Roberts, nice pass. Shelby Cloninger, and Roberts lays it in. 16-point lead. In the lane, shot no good that time by Erickson. Offensive rebound by Martin, missed a shot. And Martin goes down. And Varco with a foul? No, they call it on Cloninger. That's her fourth. Norman back in, Landeck back in. Case and Smith get a breather. Fourth foul on Shelby Cloninger. Midgley in the lane, a runner, doesn't go. Varco grabs the Cardinal rebound. Landeck, Cloninger open three. Rattles, doesn't drop. And a foul called on Grace Varco. Or check that. Yeah, I can't tell. They don't put it on the scoreboard. I'm just happy they got somebody running the clock. 8:10 remaining. I'm just telling it like it is. Never one to mince words, I guess. Almost a steal by Shelby. Good hustle. .804 remaining. Cardinals 2-3 zone. Stolen by Cloninger. Shelby. Landeck shoots to three. Too strong. Norman with an offensive rebound. And she's fouled by Thomas. Stormy Van Bell in the ballgame for Shelby Cloninger. 7:47 remaining. Norman. Called for the double dribble. Gardens with full court pressure. And a steal by Landeck. Roberts. Back to Monica. She'll wait till her teammates come back down. Stormy Van Bell is fouled. And Taylor Thomas again. Tuimana back in the ball game, replacing Thompson. Roberts. Norman, a long three. Too strong. And run down by Colorado Northwestern. Ahead to Reynolds. Reynolds stops and puts it in. Quickly, Landeck from the baseline. Monica Landeck with a nice 15-foot jump shot. Just under 7 minutes remaining. Offensive foul to Amana. Ran right into Grace Varco. And Grace, well, she doesn't move when people run into her. I kid around with Grace. This is a great group of young ladies. And I say to Grace, what do you do when somebody's barreling on you? She says, well, I just make sure my feet are set. Ahead, Norman. Nice pass by Landeck, and Norman with a lay-in. Cardinals have really got it going here in the second half. Reynolds tries to get it inside. Varco ends up with it. Macy Benedict, who's in the ballgame, has it. And Macy traveled. 5 replacements for Colorado Northwestern. Rodriguez, Prescott, Midgley, Erickson, and Martin in the ball game. Counting down to 6 minutes remaining. Nice pass in the lay-in. Is good that time by Erickson. Grace rumbling down the lane out to Landeck. Benedict for three. Got it. Macy Benedict with a long range three. Cardo bench chanting defense. Boy, they've had it here in the second half. Ooh, traveled. I think Erickson might have got away with one. She was fouled. She'd go to the free throw line to shoot two. And if I don't really concentrate on the fingers of the official, I can't tell who the foul was because they don't put it up on the board. I believe it was on Grace Varco. Varco will come out. Well, no, she won't. Stormy Van Bell will come out. One more for Erickson, 67% free throw shooter. Don't forget, we'll have a scoring recap right after the ball game. Hit the Landeck. Norman. Cloninger. In the lane, shot up. Glass, and it counts. Shelby Cloninger with a runner off the glass, and it counts. Cardinals with their largest lead of 20. One. Thompson back in the ball game. Cardinals average 83 and a half a game, giving up 63. Colorado Northwestern averages 68 while giving up 46. So actually their defense has been pretty good, but boy, not here today. Cardinals have really put it to the Spartans here in the second half. And kick ball by Cloninger. One thing I like about Shelby, she always got a smile on her face. She likes to play. Three ball does not go by Midgley. Offensive board to Martin. Rodriguez got it. That's a three. Kind of surprised that Colorado Northwestern hasn't tried to press a little bit. 4:20 remaining in the ball game. Cloninger looking for the ball inside. Lendeck with a three. Doesn't get it. Rebound to Rodriguez. Midgley, Rodriguez for three. Monica Landeck. Under 4 minutes remain. Inside Varco. Grace has a shot blocked. And held ball, possession arrow points to North Idaho College as Macy Benedict goes to the floor with Sarah Midgley. And we have a media timeout. 3:34 remaining. We'll be back after the break.
Hi, Jim, Sonny, and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources, from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Cardinals outscoring the Spartans 36-17 in this second half, including a 15-0 run in the third quarter. Cardinals outscoring Colorado Northwestern 24-9 in that period. And the official at the scores table, I'm not quite sure what that's about. 3:34 remaining. Both teams with four team fouls, so. And now more discussion. Usually it's about a shot clock, but I'm not sure. Officials, you can see just to the left of the reflection on your the floor here at Colorado Northwestern. So I'm not quite sure what's happening there. Don't forget, we'll have the men's game coming up right after this. The men's special guest. The halftime guest will be Ziggy Satterwhite. So make sure you stay around for that. We'll have a quick recap then probably about a five-minute breather, and we'll be ready for the second game of our doubleheader. Kloninger for three. Doesn't go. Rebound comes down to Prescott, who has been shut out in the second half. She had a game-high 18 in the first half. Nada in the second. Kloninger with a steal. Cardinals with a two-on-one. Over Benedict lays it up and in. Nice pass by Shelby, and Benedict with a finish. Cardinals back up by 20. Counting down 3 minutes remaining. Jocelyn Cook-Cox back in the ball game. Marlatt also in the ball game from the left elbow. No good as Midgley. Kylie Olson getting some playing time for the Cardinals. .239 remaining in the ball game. Three ball for Midgley. Does not go. Marlatt with a defensive rebound. Cardinals with a 15-0 run to start the third period and just really took the heart and soul out of this Spartan team in that period of time. 12 on the shot clock. Benedict cut off by Midgley. Inside Kloninger. Over the lip of the rim and puts it in. Shelby Kloninger giving the Cardinals a 22-point lead. 2 minutes remaining. Midgley, bounce pass. Martin lays it in. Good play. Offensive foul. And it's on Kloninger, and I think that's her fifth. Kloninger comes out. Snurmy Van Bell comes in. Nice ball game for Shelby. And five substitutions for Colorado Northwestern. We'll see if we can't get them here. As Brian Ortmeier, Kanani Naipo in the ball game for the first time. And we'll get you the others when we can. Thomas. Harvey. Offensive foul. Reynolds plowing right over the top of Jocelyn Cook-Cox. And the bench always enjoys a nice defensive play. And they're hooping and hollering. Going to make that long bus ride home very nice for the Lady Cardinals. And let's hope that the men can do the same thing. Counting down to 1 minute remaining. Macy Benedict, a three. Got another one. Macy Benedict, the dagger shot from beyond the arc. Under a minute remaining. Marlatt with a foul after the nice move by Taylor Thomas to get into the lane. Grace Varco getting set to come back in the ball game. And not sure. And Marlatt, I believe that's her fifth foul. It was. So Charity Marlatt fouls up. Hello to everybody in Cranbrook, British Columbia, Canada. I didn't give all my shout-outs that I always do, but I certainly appreciate you watching our broadcast here on NICAthletics.com. We'll have men's action on the webcast starting December 28th with the Coeur d'Alene Invitational. We'll have games Wednesday or Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and then conference play starts once again in January, 35 seconds remaining. Benedict, 9 seconds on the shot clock. Long three, Macy, too strong, gets her own rebound. Macy, reverse lay-in, puts it in. Macy Benedict, 24-point Cardinal lead, 19 seconds remaining. stole by Macy. Benedict in the front court. 6 seconds remaining. And Macy's going to run out the clock. And there it is. There's your final. The Lady Cardinals win it big, 80-56. Coming up in just a couple of minutes, we'll have our scoring recap and some shooting stats right after the break.
All right, let's have the quarterly report. Bill, good luck.
Thank you. I would like you to, if you would, look at the...
What's going on, buddy?
What I'm...
We know what's on your mind. That's why Numerica is there with financial solutions, including a 24/7 mobile app designed to take the stress away and give you every opportunity to live well. Numerica. Life moves. Live well.
So are you all seeing what I'm seeing?
Hi, Jim Sunny and the whole friendly staff at Parker Toyota are ready to help with your car shopping. Start your research at parkertoyota.com. You can link to a number of industry sources from third-party information, from fuel economy and trade-in values to safety ratings. And all our inventory is online to save you time. In the end, you'll need to get behind the wheel to finish your research with a test drive with the friendly folks at your locally owned Parker Toyota in Coeur d'Alene.
I'm Bobby Enslow, and I own Indaba Coffee in West Central. West Central is such a tight-knit, diverse community. True change has to come from within. STCU has empowered those people within the neighborhood to make that change happen. It's really the cooperative work of all the members that help fund the awesome projects going on in West Central and all the other neighborhoods. Being an STCU member, you're helping be a part of the change that's going on in West Central. STCU is here for good.
Idaho is a place where simple pleasures and modern life come together beautifully. Our strong, self-sufficient work ethic and down-to-earth values help make our dreams real. At Idaho Central, we think your financial partner should reflect the independent, can-do spirit of your Idaho roots. As we celebrate 75 years serving our great state, Idaho Central invites you to rethink the way you bank and join the leading credit union with Idaho in its name.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
When looking for a vehicle, what do you want? A big selection? The lowest price? More for your trade? Great customer service? Or do you want it all? Tom has it all at Lake City Ford. Come see our showroom with the easiest and friendliest sales staff you'll find anywhere. Giant factory rebates on America's best-selling truck, Ford F-Series. And at Lake City Ford, you can always buy new Fords at bargain prices every day of the week. Nobody sells, services, and discounts Fords like Coeur d'Alene's Ford Giant. Tom Addis, Lake City Ford, 315 Clayton Avenue in Coeur d'Alene, or visit us at lakecityford.com.
Welcome back to Rangeley, Colorado. Big victory there for the Cardinals, 80-56. Dick Haugen here. What a ball game it was, and what a third quarter. Well, I can actually expand that to what a great second half for the Cardinals. Here's your shooting stats and scoring recap. Cardinals shooting 43% in the ball game, however, shooting 53% in that second half. Cardinals 43% for the ball game, 25% from beyond the arc, 70% from the free throw line. Cardinals with three players in double figures, led by the 17 points of Macy Benedict, 15 for Shelby Cloninger, and 14 for Monica Lamdeck. Other scores for NIC: Norman with 6, 8 for Van Bell, Roberts with 4, 2 for Case, 4 for Cook Cox, 4 for Barco, and Charity Marlatt with 6 points in the ball game. For Colorado Northwestern, they only shot 25% in that second half, 12% from beyond the arc as the Cardinal defense was simply outstanding, going on a 15-0 run to start the second half. Leading scorer for Colorado Northwestern, Rachel Prescott, had 18 points in the first half. She was shut out in the second half as the Cardinals play just an outstanding second half of basketball here in Rangeley, Colorado. So with the victory, the Cardinals improved to 11-2 overall. They are 2-1 in conference play. Colorado Northwestern, they're 0-4 in conference play. They are 8-8 overall. So a big victory for the Lady Cardinals here in Rangeley, Colorado. Don't forget, we'll have the men's game coming up, our pregame show, in just about 8 minutes from right now. This is Dick Halkin. Thanks for joining us here this afternoon. We'll be back with the Cardinal men in just about 8 minutes.